Very good. Thank you. Very beautiful question. And I feel this is very good for everyone to hear. Because there's this feeling that, okay, yes, so much peace is here. But then is this self-realization? What am I supposed to do next to realize the self? Because what I'm after is to really, truly realize the self. So what about if we do this right now and finish it off? What if we could just realize the self right now and see that this is my true self? So self-realization is only this seeing that I am this pure awareness itself and I could never have been this person. It's just this simple seeing. And then you see that all moves through the will of the being which is present here. All that moves is only through the will of the being which is present here. So even rebirths will happen through your will as God. It will not be contrary to your will. So the presence here, the God here, the consciousness here, I amness, is the one doer and the one experiencer. So all moves in accordance with His will. See? And this beingness is you. And ultimately, we can say that this beingness also is born within you and dissolves within you. Therefore, is made up of awareness alone. So nothing can happen to you contrary to your will. Even rebirth. Rebirth will only happen if it is your will that you want some more of this phenomenal experiencing. If you had enough of this phenomenal experiencing, then I don't feel that it can happen. So I'm speaking to you as consciousness itself. Obviously, all of this cannot depend on the whims and fancies of a person. So we cannot have a conversation like this with the mind because the mind cannot understand this. But you as consciousness, somewhere, it must be ringing true what is being spoken here. Even if the mind comes to resist, even that resistance is seen, but somewhere something must be ringing true. That's why these words are also emerging like this. So let's look at this self-realization. And for this realization of the self, we have this simple question that we can ask, which is, am I aware now? Put aside just for a few moments, all of you can put aside this resistance that self-realization cannot be this simple. This thought will come that it cannot be this. Or even if it is this, then I have to abide in it or something like that. Just put all of that aside. And just very innocently ask yourself this question, am I aware now? And you will not see anything. If you're seeing a visual which is pretending to be awareness, reject that visual also. Don't give any belief to that. Just simply, am I aware now? And like this, in great simplicity, you will find that awareness is here. Yes, I am aware. But how do I know this? Because there is awareness even of awareness itself. This simply like this is the realization of the self. And it cannot leave you. It cannot leave you, you see. You are that. You are this. And this awareness is the awareness which is aware of the entire universe of phenomenal appearance. So the appearance of Nirmayi will come and go, but the awareness which is aware of nothing and something, which is aware of mind and no mind, which is aware of body and no body, aware of world and no world, this awareness you are. This is the self. And you are realizing it. Very simple like this. So self-realization actually is the simplest thing, simpler than simple. That is why it's completely impossible for the mind. That which needs no effort is completely impossible for the mind, because the mind is only focused on what should I do, like you were saying, what next, you see, like this. This is all the language that the mind understands. And this is a tendency which is getting released now. This is a very deep, very primal tendency, very deep conditioning that what do I do next? Yes, I have understood and there's peace now, but what do I do now? You see this. So this also will get burnt in this fire of satsang, as long as we don't feed it with something. That's why I'm not giving you a practice, you see, because to give you a practice would be to feed it with something. Which means it would give some validity to this question. What next, or what do I do? If I give you something, it is like giving this tendency something to eat and make it stronger. What is here right now is not concerned about the next. It is only the voice of this mind which says what next. You are the self, you have only been the self. You cannot become a non-self even if you try. You cannot become the person even if you give it all your attention and belief. You can only pretend, you can never become it. Because there is always the awareness which is aware even of this play of pretending to be a person and the withdrawal from pretending to be the person. Isn't it? This you which is aware that you are aware. It's not a complicated sentence. You are aware that awareness is here. You are aware that you are aware. This one is prior to the mind. I am aware. I am awareness. And the mind is not a party to this conversation, because it doesn't know what the hell we are talking about. Because awareness is so, so far beyond its realm of understanding that it has no clue right now. You see? So that's why for some of you it might be a little resistive, some frustration might be coming. Because it doesn't know. So even this monkey, let it jump around and just throw all the tantrums it wants. Some kids have this ability that when they throw tantrums, they can become blue. You see? When they come in the toy shop, they can hold their breath and become blue. And that can cause some fear. But this one, let the mind throw whatever tantrum it is saying. Let it say, I don't understand, this is too difficult, this path is not for me, why am I stuck here? So all this rubbish can come. But you see that there is an awareness even of this tantrum. Whatever the mind could be saying. And you will never find yourself, if you were to just look, you will never find yourself in the content. You will never find yourself in the appearance. You will always see that I am this awareness itself. Because if I was to ask you, what is the distance between yourself and this awareness, what would you say? No distance. So that which is at no distance from me, that which is of no separation from me, then I must be that, isn't it? What do we call that? Which is of no distance and has no separation from me, then that must be me itself. So this pure seeing can never find any separation. Can find nothing that distinguishes this seeing from I, the absolute I. Therefore, I must be this awareness itself.